Ready.
The U.S. Open champion last fall serves for the Aussie Open here in 2011. And opens with an ace. She hasn't had many of those in the entire championship. In fact, 8 in the first 6 matches. Total of 8. Just missed.
30 love.
Turned pro in 97. First made a dent in a tournament in 99. And here are her results coming into the championship final. And a quick 40 love lead.
40 love.
She works very quickly, probably the fastest in the WTA Tour. Has not lost a set.
Took 3 tie breaks to get to this final.
Game.
At love, Clijsters has the opening game.
Let's slow it down to Pam Shriver. Pam?
Well, Mary Jo, before I spoke to Lee Nan's husband, Dennis, I also spoke to Kim Clijsters' husband, Brian Lynch, and he said the day was pretty good, except something of concern to him was that when Kim woke up from her nap this afternoon, and she does nap the days of night matches, she woke up with a stiff neck. I'll tell you what, after that service game, it looked pretty good to me. But it's always a concern when you carry any little little niggling injury in a big match like this.
There's Brian Lynch in the second row. Second from the inside. It was a good start for Clijsters, who, even though she hasn't dropped a set, Dick, didn't play her best really until the semifinal a couple days ago against Zvonareva.
Now, Lina, let's see how her nerves will hold up. Wild miss. Infinity player profile of Lina. 5'8", about the same height as Kim. Wuhan, China, the population almost as large as the entire country of Belgium, central China. And she rallied from match point down against number one Wozniacki to make it to the final, the first Asian woman, first Chinese woman, obviously, ever to reach a Grand Slam final.
It was a very nervous start against Wozniacki, and a little bit of the same, understandably, in her first major final. She got down a set in 4-2. At 4-3 was down 40 love, then saved the match point at 5-4 with a forehand winner.
And had a horrible start in Sydney in the finals 2 weeks ago against Kim. Love 5 down and still won it.
Holds it love, breaks it love, too low. Kim Clijsters. There's the prize money, nearly $2.2 million to the champion, and half that amount to the runner-up. If win or lose, it'll be the biggest payday ever for Lina. Finally, a point for Lenon.
A hard-earned point. Could have hit a couple extra shots. Even what seemed to be an easy put-away right here came back. Good anticipation from Clijsters. And a big sigh after she hit the winner from Lena.
Well, she's an aggressive player, Lena. She'll go for the lines. She can have trouble keeping the ball in the court. This was the problem with Wozniacki the first set and a half. But when she gets in a zone, watch out. Lena walking as if she thought it was an ace. A challenge here. Allison.
A late call, but it was a correct call from here. Yeah.
Allison Lang confirming from her spot in the chair that the ball was out, so no challenge. Forehand winner.
Not easy to hit an outright winner on Clijsters from behind the baseline, but Lena has that ability. Got a little more margin on that forehand. This is where Lena really has to take advantage of the set short ball she's going to get on the second serve. Didn't get ahead in the point. And they both know that the other one's going to try to have that first strike in the rally. So that puts a little added pressure to do a little bit more right away.
That was part of the game plan of Kim Clijsters coming into this season, to move closer to the baseline, try to get the ball earlier, put pressure on her opponents, work in this championship. Another forehand hit with a little too much thrust. Brian Lynch in the second row, rubbing his chin. His family back in Belmar, New Jersey, had their alarm set for 3 in the morning and are with us in our live coverage here on ESPN2. Wim Fazette in the red cap, her coach. Well, it's been fair or foul on that forehand for Lena in this game.
Well, she's had the bigger numbers throughout the tournament. She definitely goes for more sooner. And she will stick to this. There's really no plan B with her game. She will continue to be aggressive.
First night match of the tournament for Lena, and it is the hottest night. The balls are flying pretty good down here. The heat wave is moving in. You could start to feel it move in a couple hours ago. I think that Lena, that'll favor Lena a little bit, that it's like the daytime heat that she's used to.
Losing the first 8 points of this championship match, comes back to break Clijsters, and it's 1-2 in the opening set.
Now she can settle in. Butterfly should be gone.
Mm-hmm. And a couple of solid serves for a 30-love lead.
30-love.
Rose tattoo on the chest of Lena. You see that? It's a mark of her independence. Pam Shriver very accurately described that strong character of this Chinese woman. She got that tattoo 10 years ago.
Looking at some of Lina's results through the last few years, and so often is the case where she is down in a match, whether she loses a first set and down a break, and she finds a way to come back. A very big fighter. Clijsters said after the Sydney final, when she lost to Lena, that she couldn't find a weakness. She didn't really know where to hit to. The forehand, she said yes and made more errors, but also hit so many winners.
Of service by holding for two all. Well, a pulse question here on ESPN2. Will Lena become the first Asian to win a major? Yes or no? Or yes, but not tonight? There are three options for you. Let's check on what you think. Don't forget men's final tomorrow, 3 o'clock in the morning Eastern time, midnight in the West. Novak Djokovic and Andy Murray. And then a repeat at 9 in the morning, so those of you who don't want to get up and see it live, pretend it didn't happen and tune in at 9 o'clock here on ESPN2 for all the action.
15 love.
Well, that last return, besides considering the first 8 points and Lena looking so nervous, what a great turnaround in the last two. Just turned it on a dime. Still early at 2-all, but already a couple of shifts.
I think we're going to see a lot of shifts and momentum changes in this match because they both can be quite streaky. Clijsters had a lot of up and downs in most of her matches, said she needed to find her rhythm and felt she found it against Zvonareva in the semifinals.
Not a lot of canter in their games. They go full gallop. Full force baseline bashing. Ball at this end hit by Lena looked to be long, but the play continued. 30-15. Close at the other end. Just missed.
Good placement on that first serve from Clijsters. Against Lena, a solid returner. You really have to keep her guessing.
First touch shot. Scores for Lena.
You don't see a change of play that often from Lena. but great disguise. Kim was not expecting the drop shot at all. At the last minute, went to the one-handed backhand. Great finesse.
And the hold for Clijsters. They're on serve. It's the opening set. The finals of the Australian Open.
MGD64s.
Rod Laver Arena here at Melbourne Park. The Australian Open Championships down to their final two events. The women's final tonight, men's final tomorrow night. Kim Clijsters with a 3-2 lead in the opening set against Lena. And trying to become the first Asian ever to win a major. Lena serves 2-3. She's the oldest finalist in a long time here at the Open, going back to Chris Evert in 1988. 23 years. Chris lost that year to Steffi Graf. Good defensive lob by Clijsters. They had to restart the point. Lena had a little trouble with that overhead in her win against Wozniacki.
Catches the backhand a little bit late. She redirects her backhand so well. A lot like Kim Clijsters, changes from across court to down the line beautifully.
Misses with the backhand again, and a love 30 hole for the Chinese woman.
Li Na has swings of emotion on the court. She was actually a little upset with herself that she hit that overhead. I think she realized as deep as she was in the court, it was probably going long, and she's been a little peeved at herself those last 2 points.
She misses two backhands and then steps up and cracks one. There's no let up in her game.
That's a lot of weight behind her backhand. Leans into it beautifully. Has great disguise. Tremendous moving from Clijsters.
15, 14.
To me, she turns a defensive point into an offensive point better than anyone.
Burning two break points to reclaim the lead.
Side that rally. They're both hitting it low over the net. Li Na has the lowest clearance of anybody in this tournament, and Kim was trying to match her there.
Well, it's interesting because they both really are looking to do the same thing off that backhand cross court, pull the trigger down the line, but it's coming at them with so much pace, they really have to be picky about when they do it.
Another break point. Got away with a 83 mile an hour second serve. Free point.
Oh.
Long stare from Clijsters. Call is out. Is she going to challenge? She asks umpire Lang if she saw it out. She is going to challenge.
The ball was called out.
British umpire. Good call.
Advantage lead.
Pam, you were mentioning the net clearance, and on average, it's been Lee Na who's been closer to the net, but so far, 27 inches for Clijsters and 30 for Lee Na. So yeah, she is trying to match her.
Lee Na was like at 18, 19 inches in her match in the quarterfinals. So she's definitely giving it more air tonight, perhaps part of the strategy of being in a major final.
From Clijsters after she'd made a terrific move to bunt that ball deep on the drop shot from Lee Na.
It's interesting, though. I think that's part of the strategy, too, from Lee Na to throw in some shorter balls, because Clijsters does camp out if she's having to defend behind the baseline, get her moving forward, not on her own terms.
Lee Na set that return up for Clijsters, but she slaps it wide.
You know, I always think when you think about major championships and where they're won and lost, these two players are going to drop serve a lot tonight, but it's who can sort of guts out these tough, tough service games, fighting off break points and persevering through. We'll see if this is a big one for Lee Na or not.
She saved two breakers. Back to deuce.
Composure there, Lee Na. You can hear the crowd when you see the split move by Clijsters in amazement. But then a beautiful inside out forehand to finish off the point.
That's a big save for Lee Na. In trouble, saves two break points, three all. She is the Chinese tennis pioneer. First to win a WTA Tour event, that was 7 years ago. First to reach the quarters of a major, Wimbledon, 5 years ago. She made it to the semifinals, beaten by Savonareva for the bronze medal in Beijing. And, of course, the first to be top 30, top 20, top 10, and if she wins tonight, top five. She is assured of number seven if Clijsters wins, but number five in the world if she is successful in winning this championship.
And from love two down, she's looking like your winner right now. But as Mary Jo said, there are going to be a few shifts in this match.
Watching Lee Na through the years, and she's always been a dangerous player, someone who can catch on fire and beat anyone on any given day, but mentally she was not that strong, and that's where she's really improved. She's having a little trouble there, huh, Pam?
Yeah. Last night it was seagulls, tonight it's a couple of big bugs, but it's showing her character a little bit, her realization of the moment, and have a little light moment with a bug.
And the young ball kid didn't know quite what to do with the bug. About to put it in the Avion box.
15-13.
But it seems now with Lena mentally being a little bit tougher, when she does dip in play, she recovers much faster. Defensive skills from Lee Na.
15-14.
A little tentative from Clijsters at the net. Could have done a little bit more with this one right here. Guides it back in, and good scrambling ability from the Chinese woman.
Yeah, I think it was the missed overhead earlier by Kim. Made her back off that one. Cost her the point.
And two break points for the Chinese player. Ninth Australian Championships, the women first vied for this coveted title in 1922. And the first American to win here in Australia was Dorothy Bundy Cheney, or Dodo Cheney, still playing at La Jolla Beach and Tennis Club and winning senior titles. 1938, the first American to win on the women's side. Of course, that was the same year that Don Budge completed the calendar Grand Slam with a win in Australia. Those times it was played in December. It was the last of the four.
She had trouble controlling it. May have been pre-match nerves. There's new balls this service game. Good hold so far up 30 love. A good start.
Yeah, a little more margin with the forehand, getting good top spin. Remember that shot can be the one to break down when things get tight, but looks like she's found her timing and her rhythm nicely here.
First double fault. Make that her second, Lena. Clijsters yet to commit a double fault. Prior to this championship final, Clijsters guilty of twice as many double faults as Lena. 17-8. Able to get that forehand inside the baseline and hits it long. Big point here for Clijsters after losing her serve. 30 all. This time it's Lee Na with a midcourt ball that misses badly, and break point with it.
Did the right thing. She had Clijsters on the defense. After hitting this backhand cross court, moves in to take the ball of the air, but then a little hesitation.
It's changing light down here. It's going from more daytime into the twilight. It's a little more difficult to hit balls in the air this time of day.
So Clijsters is now 1-for-4 break points, while Lena 2-for-2.
mishitting that last backhand. She's been being pushed around the court a little bit more right now, Clijsters.
Well, when she won the quarterfinal match, Lena, when asked about what would happen if you should win the title for your country, she said, well, they forget. 1 month, they'll forget. She's wrong about that.
I don't think so.
You can imagine the tens, maybe hundreds of millions watching on television in China this event tonight. And what impact this is going to have on the young girls watching Lena, and how many of those courts are going to be busy tomorrow? Saving a break point, Lena holds 5-3, and Clijsters serves to stay in the match. As if there isn't enough weight on the shoulders of these two women. Look at Lena in her vision. Oh, that too?
It's a reminder. What's at stake? That was at dinner last night, Dick, the Chinese restaurant, and I was asking the waiters and the cooks about what this would mean. That one sails for China, and everybody was sort of in agreement that she's a winner regardless of tonight's outcome, whether she wins or loses this final, that this will be huge, that there will be young girls tomorrow practicing on all the courts that they've built. I mean, they've already made a big push. They have the Masters in Shanghai for the men. Beijing has a combined event. They've had the Olympics, so the structure's there.
30,000 courts in the country. Clijsters now at love 30, 2 points away from dropping this opening set.
Well, who would have thought after the first two games where Clijsters did not drop a point that she would find herself down so quickly? What a quick turnaround.
Clijsters box.
They might want to brighten up their energy level a little bit. They were looking a bit glum.
And with that forehand nailed in the corner, two set points for Lena.
Clijsters has not lost a set this entire tournament.
Dennis, he says, is this American tag? Appreciate the unity of mind and body in the game of tennis, and she gave all of that in 38 minutes for a opening set, and the emotions with it. Little come on from her husband and coach, who was a Davis Cup player. They've been married 5 years. They weren't quite sure whether the anniversary was 2 days ago or today. Nevertheless, they've been married 5 years. They had a lot of fun with that in the post-game interview after the semifinal win.
A little more focused on matters at hand at the moment. What a great turnaround in that set for Lena. being down two love, hadn't won a point, broke right back, and then saved a couple big break points, down 3-2. And she really is taking it to Clijsters. She's the one dictating more often than not. Clijsters on the change of ends looked a little bit down.
This is what Lena has done throughout the championship. She has been a tremendous defender. She has broken her opponent's serve 33 times out of 53. That's 62% starting tonight, and then 3 for 5 breaking Clijsters in that opening set. So the pattern continues, and with the break in that last game, she serves with the lead to open the second set.
Pressure really on Clijsters now to do a little bit more, to take a little more risk than she did in that first set. Get inside the baseline.
You know, the three major finals Clijsters has won, they've been in straight sets. So it'll be interesting to see if she can win it in three.
Those three being United States Open Championships. She did reach the finals here at the Australian Open 7 years ago and lost to countrywoman Justine Enna, who has announced her retirement during the course of this Australian Open fortnight. But there's another Belgian woman coming. Junior girls won by a Belgian today. Oh, the net court, it still hit the line. Double luck.
30-15.
Continuing to play her bold style of game. It's this forehand that does the damage right on that baseline. Gives her the short ball.
She's had success serving down the tee. Slice, 40-15.
What is her service percentage tonight?
61% for the match. She's winning 65% when she gets her first serve in.
Clijsters taking charge in that point.
40-30.
She's got to find a way to turn some of these points around, make them look the way she wants them to look.
Yeah, from two love up, she's been a bit passive and almost like she took for granted that things would continue to roll her way. She has got to turn this around on her own racket.
Just to follow through on the Belgian girl who won the girls' title here today, and Sophie Mestak, her name, from Belgium, winning the juniors' title. And sad for Australia, they had a young guy, Luke Seville, get to the finals of the boys, but beaten by a Czech, Jiří Veselý, 6-love, 6-3. Clijsters picking up the attack here to open the second set, and she has a break point.
Yeah.
Ms. Lee is challenging the call on the right center serve. The ball's called out.
Lena, I thought she had an ace. Second serve, break point. Truly is stunning under pressure how she doesn't give herself a lot of room for error. She's firing at the lines, misses some, but there's a tough cross-court backhand just inside the line. Deny break point.
To quote Lena, I am strong woman. She is showing that so far tonight.
When you take a look at the patterns on her serve for Lena, she really likes the slice serve on both sides, but particularly on the ad side. Only one first serve has gone out to the backhand of Clijsters. Every other one has gone up the tee to the forehand. There's a changeup. Even though it's just the first game of the second set, that it's a big game.
That was to secure this opening game after facing a break point.
Lena wants to continue with her belief. Stay ahead of Clijsters. Clijsters wants to establish herself somehow back in this match.
And another break point for Clijsters. Lena, 8 winners, 14 unforced. Clijsters, 6 and 11, so the percentage is about the same. More unforced errors as they both go for it than winners. Double fold, and the game to Clijsters. She takes the early lead in the second set. Let's go to room 22, Chris and Brad.
Big thank you. So, Brad, you were calling for Clijsters to make some adjustments. You thought Lena did a better job of being flexible with her game in the first set.
Yeah, there's no question. Lena playing with a lot more spin on the forehand than we've seen all tournament. And to me, Kim Clijsters obviously got those first two games. She kind of got them gifted to her. And as Lena made adjustment in her game, Kim has stayed the same course. I'd like to see her mix in a couple of loops, maybe a couple of angles, and take the air out a little bit, then attack. But just standing on the baseline and trying to attack is playing into Lena's hand.
All three of Kim's wins in Grand Slam finals, she had won the first set in the last 17 major finals won by the woman who was taken. The opening set, is it an upset in the making here, Dick?
Clijsters fighting and finally able to break. In part because of the wild play of Lena, but it's that same aggressive action that has earned her the opening set 6-3. Winner of the first set, it's won the last 17 finals here. Wow, let's see if that correlates tonight.
Lena.
She does let you in, doesn't she, to her emotions, what she's going through.
Jackie just has been a delight, comedic, impressive. Really embraced her personality. Says her mother won't watch at home. Gets too nervous. Sensor, your mother never watches you play. She said, she waits. If I win, she turns on tape.
Using the whole court beautifully. What a great angle, and then hitting to the open court.
And Mom might want to turn on the tape at that last point a few times, but it had a few changes up of the pace that Brad Gilbert was talking about by Kim Clijsters, but she lost the point anyway.
Clijsters stopped the point, thought the ball was out. And so Allison Lang will call for the review. You saw the roof is open. Very warm day today, and it's going to be hotter tomorrow. And that gives Lena a break point.
Has two challenges remaining.
Chance to break back early here in the second set. If you're just joining us, Kim Clijsters out of the blocks quickly to open this championship match, won the first 8 points, held at love, broke at love, had a 2-love lead, looked as if it was going to be easy. Then Lena broke back in the 2-love game, broke again and again, two more times late in the set to win at 6-3. Backhand was a little mishit, just enough to throw off Clijsters, dumping it into the net. Another break point. This one right here. Lena's done it again. Breaks back, one all.
Let's go inside the point and take a look at Lena. She's really been trying to get ahead in the rally, dictate play as soon as possible, and she's done it many times with her forehand, and particularly cross court. She's been hitting behind Clijsters quite often. Clijsters forced to go to the split, to the defensive move, and she's got the little short angle that Gilbert was talking about that Clijsters should be hitting. Well, we've seen it more often from Lena. She's really used the whole court well, as you take a look at the IBM match update.
Three straight service games Clijsters broken, and four times in the match.
It seems like Lena came out with more of a plan of what she wanted to do. We saw the drop shot earlier played, the forehand cross courts. And Clijsters waiting a little bit too much, almost waiting for the errors instead of trying to control her game and make the right plays. You don't get a clear picture of what Clijsters is trying to do in the rallies.
We first saw Lena making some noise 3-4 years ago. I don't recall her hitting with so much power. Maybe it's just the confidence.
She just missed so much more.
Clijsters is going to have to call upon that kind of defense, her trademark, to rally. That won the point for her. Saturday night, down under, Melbourne, Australia, just after 8:30 in the evening. 5:30 early evening in Wuhan, in China. 10:30 in Belgium in the morning.
It's a big risk right there. Going for so much from so far off the court.
Another break chance for Clijsters. Much like the Caroline Wozniacki semifinal with Lena, the rallies are very physical, and not too many of them won on a point, but lost by a player. But heavy slugging.
They both are hitting heavy. Lena doing a little bit more of it than Clijsters, and you just feel like Clijsters feels very confused.
Caught the baseline there.
On the right
baseline. Or did she? Allison Lang on the challenge from Lena.
And if she loses it, she's only going to have one left for the set. It's a long way to go. But she's right. Way right.
Advantage.
Second break point in this game.
Lee has one challenge remaining.
Lee thought it was out.
I'm clearly confused, but she's down to one challenge.
Opportunity here for Clijsters. Second serve on a break point.
Okay. Flips the net. It's good. Three straight breaks of service to open this second set.
Fasten your seatbelts for a huge night of big
of daylight on this Saturday night. I'm with Mary Jo Fernandez, twice a finalist here at the Australian Open, and Hall of Famer Pam Shriver down at courtside. Lee Na of China continuing in her quest for added history in Chinese sport. She's already become the first Asian woman to reach a final of a major tennis championship. And trying to go back to central China, Wuhan, her home province, with the trophy. Kim Clijsters has other ideas. She's never won this title, all three of her majors at the U.S. Open.
Clijsters really struggling on serve in this match. Winning less than half the points when she gets her first serve and not really going after it.
You know, thinking back to what Brian Lynch told me just before the match, that the only point of concern for him was when Kim woke up from her nap with a stiff neck. To me, whenever I've had, I mean, to me, the serve can hurt you the most if your neck's a little bit off. And, you know, who knows? She may not say a word.
But maybe that's why she's spinning more of them than usual.
Her fastest, Clijsters serve, 105 and change. And the fastest for Lena, 104 and a half. About the same. 15, well, the first 30. Time that I had the honor to visit the People's Republic of China, 1973, first sportscaster to go in and call a competitive match, the men and women's basketball team from the U.S. playing the Chinese men and women. And the women tore apart the United States team with just great shooting. And then the men just destroyed the Chinese men, who didn't quite understand the idea of setting screens and picks. They followed their man wherever he went, and sometimes it was a parade of layups for the American men. But the women were solid. So it's no surprise, as that country designates its young stars, that there'll be excellence in every sport, and Chinese trailing some of the other sports, but Lina must have that country on its edge tonight.
Break point.
Well, that's really good luck at break point for Clijsters.
Yes.
Well, they say it all evens out, Mary Jo. Remember the one earlier that Lena hit the net cord that went on the baseline?
Very powerful play. And the Chinese woman, she's taking that first serve so early and putting Clijsters on the defense so quickly.
Remember in the first set we said how when you battle out of those long games where your face break point down, it can really turn things around. Kim's hoping she can have one up here.
As far as this Rod Laver Arena crowd of 15,000 being treated to some wonderful championship play.
Little cat and mouse there up close at the net. Clijsters should have seen that Lina was covering the cross court, could have bunted it up the line on the short one.
Let's for service.
Another tense game, couple of break points saved by Clijsters, hanging on to a 2-1 lead, second set, trailing by a set.
Control that last point. Clijsters just got a little bit away from her. The distance between herself and the ball got too high.
Off the sideline, and how about that? Break, 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 break. Two all, second set. Well, the Australian Open continues early Sunday morning here on ESPN2 as Andy Murray, how about the British drought to win a major since 1936, meets Novak Djokovic, men's final. See which player will be crowned the champion. Australian Open 2011, presented by Franklin Templeton Investments. Early Sunday morning, 3 a.m. Eastern on ESPN2. Encore presentation Sunday at 10 a.m. Eastern, 10 o'clock. For those of you who want to ignore any phone calls or newspaper reports and look on at the championship final Sunday morning at 10 a.m., live at 3 a.m.
At the moment, both players preferring to receive. Much more aggressive from the start off the return.
Lena has had her best success
15-0.
Driving Clijsters into that backhand corner.
Surprised that there are a lot of breaks in this match. I mean, let's face it, in a year where Serena Williams, the defending champion's out, we sort of missed the biggest pressure server in women's tennis. So it's going to come down to return, and then the odd pressure hold.
And Lena struggling to hold here at 15-30.
From Clijsters there, changing the pace with the slice. I think that's a good play. You have to be prepared to run when you slice, but it forces Lena to generate her own pace. On the outside of that forehand, so well to create the angle, Clijsters.
Check on that polls question, what you folks watching this championship final think about Lena becoming the first Asian to win a major. Yes, 63% to 17. Yes, but not tonight for one-fifth of you, but the backing of the Chinese number 9 seed is obvious. And she saved another break point here, 30-40. Show you how this second set has gone roughly for the server. Every game, all five games, there's been at least two break points and four breaks of service, and five if you go back to the last game of the opening set.
Given how Clijsters has played her last three major finals, I'm a bit surprised how she's playing the big points tonight, which is not well.
Hesitating, right, Pam? Does that, from the court side, it seems like she's a little unsure of what to do on the big points. See a lot more clarity from Lena. Anything short, she's really taking it early, opening up the court. You mentioned Dick really picking on the backhand of Clijsters to put balls away.
Rare cheap point off her serve. She doesn't have an ace, Lena, but a game point.
tried for one there.
Unable to break a couple of chances in the last game. She serves 2-3, down a set.
Cool. We heard Pam yesterday, Murray, say he went to a looser racket. He needed to get a little more on his shots. He felt like he wasn't penetrating the court. Do you think Clijsters went looser there?
I think it's about 20 degrees warmer tonight, and Kim's played three night matches much cooler, so I think the conditions have surprised her tonight.
Speaking of the weather, with Djokovic and Murray playing tomorrow night for the men's final, they expect the day temperatures tomorrow to reach 105 degrees. And this is after 2 weeks of where the temperature has kind of drifted 70s and 80s, and at night even down into the 50s. But the summer heat is coming. Starting tonight.
Well, I think she might have gone a little tighter for more control. Give herself a little more room to really swing out on the ball for Clijsters, because she has been a little bit hesitant on the big points, a little unsure. So perhaps because it is warmer, she went up in tension.
For the winner.
Anticipating correctly once again.
Thank you.
Well, here's a game point for Clijsters. She hasn't held serve since back in the middle of the opening set. She's been broken four straight times. That's got to be a relief in the Clijsters camp. 3-all. Let's take a look at today's innovative thinking brought to you by Lexus.
Lee Na has been firing from all cylinders, but we've seen a little variety as well. It hasn't just been hit, hit, hit. We've seen angles. We've seen her come in a little bit, a little more topspin today. So a little bit of everything from the Chinese woman. She's defended well, and again, the angle, the depth, the power. She's had it all so far working well in her first major final.
Again, at stake, personal history for Kim Clijsters to win her first Australian Open, not the first from her country. Justine Enna defeated Clijsters for the Aussie Open Championship 7 years ago. The bigger story, of course, Lee Na, 28 years of age from Wuhan, China, central China, trying to become the first, not just Chinese, but Asian woman to win a major title, or Asian period. To win a major title.
Love the team.
this is, if you're Kim Clijsters, where you want to be a backboard. You want to make Lena hit as many shots as possible. She's going through one of her dips.
You know, a lot of the players have come in. Another big change for Lee Na has just been a step up in conditioning, and I have seen some great agility tonight, racing up for drop shots, back for the overhead, and her footwork and athleticism is at its peak right now.
Meanwhile, the replay showing that Clijsters probably should have challenged that last call. Clijsters, two break points again. As she has had in every Lee Na service game of this set. Difference in the match thus far, 5 for 10 break points Lee Na, 3 for 10 Clijsters. But here's two chances. Chinese player.
They're becoming very physical points. Both working extremely hard, that time falling away from the backhand. She's starting to hit a little bit more behind Lee Na. She's trying to generate a little bit more pace, Clijsters. That's going to serve her well, I think.
Another break point. Clijsters the lead, 4-3. It'll be tough for Lee Na to assimilate because she had the court wide open. Clijsters camped in that corner, and she hit it right to Clijsters, who finished off the game and the 4-3 lead. New balls.
Loss of concentration and frustration coming out.
Look at that. Each woman was 60 points one.
But the match has really turned in the last 3-4 minutes.
She didn't
convert here.
She, look at the court, wide open. And she hits it to Clijsters that was stuck in the corner.
And the lob looked like maybe it could have gone wide, but it was still a tough shot to make.
That was the break point last game. Air is mounting now on Lina's end, 24 in the match, 12 in this set. Another exhausting, hard-hitting rally, and it ends on an error, not a winner. And that's a consistent pattern.
Just hard to keep it up, isn't it? It's where you wish you'd see a little bit more of a change of pace, a slice, a higher ball.
Shortly after 9 o'clock, Saturday evening here in Melbourne. And her fans cheer, a game away from squaring this final.
Clijsters lead 5-3, second set.
Ran into the great Australian champion, Yvonne Goolagong-Cawley, earlier tonight, and the green outfit worn by Clijsters is to honor the Aussie star who, as a mother, won Wimbledon in 1980 in that green attire. Kim thought it'd be a nice way to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the sporting goods company. Makes that outfit, honoring Yvonne Goolagong-Cawley at the same time.
Yvonne did just take her seat in the last change of ends in the president's box, just a few away from Ken Rosewall, Wendy Turnbull, so a few of the Aussie greats of yesteryear are out.
When you think about this sport and how the Americans and Australians, especially on the men's side, dominated all the World War II, 50s, 60s, 70s into the 80s. Margaret Court herself dominating the all-time champion on the women's side in major titles. And then in the 80s, the global shift peaks here again tonight. Belgium against China. There's the Clijsters defensive split, unable to keep it in play, 30-15.
Kim's been looking up at her box, even though she's leading in this set. She's been looking up with some disgust and just did a little flick off there.
Change of pace. Lina took the bait.
I tell you, Lee Na's irritated with the crowd. Here comes an, she complained during the last change of ends to Allison Lang for people not to call out during points. And then just appealed then again, and Allison Lang for the second time has told the crowd not to do it.
And Lee Na was indicating it was the Chinese fans who were yelling out on Clijsters' ball, and then that throws her off. That they want so desperately for her to win that...
just one more added element in your first major final that you really have to block out.
Fighting to hold here in this 3-5 game to force Clijsters to serve out the set.
About Lee Na and her, the crowd and her support, she wasn't all that fabulous feeling good about it in the Olympics a couple of years ago in Beijing, and the crowd put her off then, and she actually spoke about it in during the Olympics. She is a rebel. From Clijsters on that point. Australian Open Championship. Chris?
Here's her decision making. Watch this on an easy ball. We're 6-3, 2-all. Things are in good shape. And this is where she started to really get mad. And here's a break point, and this is a turning point, I believe, in this second set.
Played it back to Clijsters, who drove it up the line to get it a break, and here's the exchange with Allison Lang.
I tell the Chinese, don't teach me how to play tennis.
I see in the chair to tell the Chinese, don't teach me how to play tennis. And there's a looping shot you're talking
and
about.
And here's a couple of loopers, and then the errant shot. It was the variety, and that started to wear down the decision-making of Lee Na.
Clijsters, besides the looping ball, is able to create 12 winners in that set. How do you see the third?
Can someone hold serve? I think if Kim keeps with this strategy, mixing it up, couple of loops, and I think she can do a little more aggressive Clijsters with her first serve. I like Clijsters' chances in the third set. Been there, done it. I favor Clijsters.
Okay, here are some stats. Now through two sets, Clijsters is still not making a great deal of impression on her serve, but the winner's coming up, limiting the errors a bit too in that set.
Yeah, she tightened things up, and for me, it was that one-dimensional play that Lee Na liked that pace, and the variety is helping.
Back to the final set to Dick and Mary Jo. All right, Chris and Brad, and Clijster is trying to build off the momentum of winning that second set 6-3. Has the first point here to open the third.
but it's her defense, Clijsters, that as this match wears on over an hour and a half, winning her points, getting that extra ball back and creating the air from her opponent, Lena.
And Lena has really come unglued down here. It's three times she's appealed to the chair umpire, who has asked the crowd not to make any out calls or noises. There was a long conversation with the chair umpire and the supervisor in between sets. But Lena is letting the crowd get to her right now, and you can't afford to do that in a major final.
Bit of a sign of inexperience at this stage for Lena, and you know, the nerves playing a part of it. I mean, she knows that the match is in her grasp as championship first major. And too many things frustrating her.
Another wild forehand. That's how this championship match began, with Clijsters holding it love and then breaking it love, and she holds it love. First foot forward here in the third set. Our Franklin Templeton featured match. Men's final tomorrow night, number 5 seed Andy Murray. Can Great Britain finally raise the championship trophy in a major against Novak Djokovic? He won this title 3 years ago. 3 o'clock a.m. Eastern, 12 o'clock in the West, and then the repeat at 10 Sunday morning for those of you who don't want to stay up into the wee hours to watch the live coverage. It's all tomorrow here on ESPN2. Meanwhile, the women's title has moved into a decisive third set.
Thank you.
Clijsters on a roll.
We have the best athlete right now in women's tennis, and Kim Clijsters. And we're going to see two of the best athletes in the men's game in tomorrow night's final.
Djokovic with a major scalp and knocking out defending champion Roger Federer. Gets that one back. And then turns her game to offense.
And she's got that ability, Dick, to do it so well. But again, like Brad was saying, the high ball, you have to be prepared to run when you change the pace, but it changes the complexion of the rally. And it forces Lena to try to come up with her own power, her own pace. And when she's not able to, then Clijsters is able to turn it around.
Well, this match opened with 8 straight points to Clijsters. She has 6 in a row to start this third set.
And Kim Clijsters would be ecstatic with seeing her opponent kind of just lose it in the last 10-15 minutes. Kim has played major finals for 10 years now, and she knows a lot of it's about just hanging in there, staying tough.
Has definitely upped the pace when given the opportunity.
Thank you.
Hitting with much more conviction.
She goes for that cross-court forehand boldly. Two more chances for the lead for the Belgian.
There's really no in-between, is there, with Lena?
But she's having to go for the lines because Clijsters has defended so well. First ace of the match. Clijsters will not challenge.
13-14. Each woman with only one ace.
She missed it. She was there. Clijsters has the lead. Too low.
She's broken Li Na now. Five out of the last six service tries for the Chinese player. It'll be a new name on that beautiful women's trophy here at the Australian Open. Serena Williams, the defending champion, out with injury. Let's not forget, Williams dominated down here. Five of the last eight. More titles than any woman in the Open era.
15-15. Kim Clijsters showed more variety, more different shots in that point than she did for about an first hour of this final.
Quite apparent that Li Na enjoys pace. Played her best tennis in that first set when they were just both going full bore on the ground strokes.
Well, it was so surprising to see Clijsters playing lower over the net, less margin, when she's the one that through the tournament gives herself more space, more margin, but she really was trying to match the power. And Li Na loved it. It's only her second double fault.
Try to secure the break of service. Li Na throughout the match has been able to break back.
Oh. Haven't seen that for some time.
Return winner down the line. Break point. In this game, two out of the three committed in the entire match. Another break point.
This is where you really want to try to keep the momentum, keep your foot on the gas.
This is where she rushes, Kim. And this, she is totally out of sync the last four service points.
Final set.
11th, presented by Franklin Templeton Investments.
Lena playing on her fifth wedding anniversary. Maybe she said she thought it was today. The book says 2 days ago she said she'd call her mother and find out for sure. All she knows is she popped the question. She asked him. 1-2, final set. Amazing defense. She's been on a tear, denying Lee on her serve to win that second set 6-3. Breaking Lena three times in the last set and in the first game of this set. They played an hour and 46 minutes. You can see the perspiration soaked outfit of Kim Clijsters. Will, with this much warmer night, conditioning be a factor?
From the middle of the court to get the angle.
Husband Brian Lynch knows all about tough competition throughout his collegiate years at Villanova, basketball and playing several years in Europe. 1 corner, winner in the other.
Such a little margin, but again, that double-handed backhand, little can go wrong. Such great technique, shoulder turn.
Metronomic rally, and again, on an error, the point ends, deuce.
I think one of the reasons we've also seen so many breaks is they're pretty predictable where they're serving, both of them. The returner really is anticipating well, knowing the patterns. Starting off, not even on neutral, sometimes ahead in the rally because they know where the serve is going.
Just one ace per side in the entire match. And a double fault for Lena. It's her fourth. Clijsters had a couple in the last game as she was broken. And here's break point to get back on top for Clijsters.
You know, it still is the shot in women's tennis that can improve the most over the next few years. 5 to 10 years, the serve has got to improve. It's gotten a little better from a few years ago.
Back in front, 3-1. Garden Square outside Rod Laver Arena, a large television screen and lots of balloons and lots of liquids. You've got to hydrate in this weather.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
$20-$25 ticket. A lot of fans taking advantage of being in the environment. Clijsters is raising the level of her play cleanly. Two errors to 10. 11 now.
You were mentioning, Dick, about the physical aspect, and if one was fitter than the other, it seems to me that Lina has slowed down. She's not getting to the ball as quickly as she was a little while ago.
Easy service game for Clijsters to 40 love.
And you like an easy service game after the one prior, your serve totally collapsed from 30-15, the two double faults, the second serve winner, and once again, Allison Lang with a warning to the crowd because of Lee Na's protests.
Lina, no room for error, serves 1-4 in this final set, down a break.
Thank you.
But that last game, she didn't offer much encouragement in her play. Both women lost their fathers at an early age. Lina's father passed away at age 14. Told your mother, very nervous, can't watch her in person, but if she wins, she'll watch the tape. And Kim Clijsters' father, the Belgian Soccer Player of the Year in his day in 1988, died 2 years ago, and it had impact on what we're watching tonight. It was out of his death that Kim Clijsters decided she'd come back to the sport.
15.
And that was further encouraged by the fact that they invited her to London, the All England Club, to play in an exhibition match to see if the retractable roof over center court would be operating successfully. And she had a good time, decided that she had game left, and returns and is playing better than she did before she gave birth to their daughter. But out of her father's death, she said it took her mind off that tragic part of her life.
And also, Dick, is a little backdrop. I believe Safina and either Yankovic were 1 and 2 at the time. That may have given her a little kick as well.
Well, she definitely had the belief that she could come back strong, and to win the U.S. Open in her third tournament back after a couple of years off was quite remarkable. Trying to find a way, Lina, to hang in there, put some pressure back on the Clijsters racket. And though it's just one break, it feels like a lot bigger of a hole.
Let's for service.
Skids that one off the sideline. Clijsters has challenged.
The ball's all good.
Just kissed the outside of the line. 40-30.
That's just 5 millimeters touching the line.
That's what they're there for.
Oh!
And the hole for Lee now. So that bolsters the hopes of her Chinese following. Let's go inside the point, Mary Jo.
Well, the big turning point in this match came when Clijsters started to mix things up, use a little bit of her variety. We know how quick she is. She could defend, but she started using the slice, forcing Lina to come out with her own power. Lina not getting enough on the pace, and that allowed Clijsters to then hit over the ball with the topspin and then go for the big power. Winner on the run. She really started the match banging too much. Well, that's well done. And now has really shown much more commitment to her different shots, to her bigger shots. Even there at the net, she closes nicely, picks the right one, and puts it away.
Knowing she has to hold only twice, and she'll raise the championship trophy.
15 all.
Holding hasn't been easy for either player in this match.
Clijsters broken six times, Lina seven.
She stopped the play. You have to stop the play to be able to challenge, and she was wrong.
Well, inside half the line.
Lee has two challenges remaining.
That's a big gamble to take at this stage in the match.
Point to Clijsters, 30-15.
Both players blown one of those tonight. Now Lina's complaining about photography. I mean,
ladies and gentlemen, please use cameras with flash.
This is such a crime to see this happen in a third and final set of a major, that she's letting the crowd and cameras and noise upend her like this.
Game.
Clijsters a game away. 5-2, final set.
Back at Rod Laver Arena, and Kim Clijsters, three times the champion of the U.S. Open, looking for her first Australian title. Fans solidly in support of their Aussie Kim. Goes back to when she was engaged to Leighton Hewitt, the Australian player. They've never forgotten the fact that she was great in this country and continues to be highly appreciative of her days in Australia.
Lina battling to hold, stay in this final set.
Looked it from here, yeah. Lee is challenging the call on the left sideline. The ball is called out.
Played such a clean set and a half, Kim Clijsters, perhaps knowing that it's all in her racket the next game, the championship, a bit loose in this game.
14-15.
She's only had four unforced errors in this final set. 14 from her opponent.
Chance to serve for a championship. Kim Clijsters, 5-3.
This is where you take a deep breath. You remember what it's like. You've been here before. And the start is always so important, the first point. Hesitation these first 2 points.
Thank you.
Surface she loves in a country that loves her. Kim Clijsters, Australian Open champion
from Belgium. Kim Clijsters.
You can feel the popularity in this Rod Laver Arena supporting Clijsters, and the dream trip to the finals for Lena ends after she had won the opening set. But Clijsters saved her best for last and takes the final set 6-3.
And it's great to see the emotions come out, how much this means to Kim, who really has a lot of the traits of an Australian. She's laid back, she's friendly. Of course, disappointing for Lena, but what an achievement to get to her first major final.
So as this championship began 2 weeks ago with Serena Williams unable to defend, the word was it's wide open. Clijsters probably the favorite to win it. She's accomplished that, but so many would have an opportunity, and that's been the storyline throughout these 2 weeks. And Lena was the one who survived the competition to get to the finals to meet the favored Clijsters and put a big scare into her as the lights start to dim here now, and we'll have the championship presentation. Came down to me, Mary Jo Fernandez, that on some crucial points from the middle of the match on, the defense of Clijsters denying what appeared to be a winning play from her opponent, and then she took the offense.
Remember, she was down a set in 3-2, held serve, and then really got the momentum. She started playing with more conviction. She mixed it up, showed her experience. I love to see the determination. She started showing a lot of emotion, positive clenched fists, and love the way she closed it out.
So they're bringing out the stage for the final presentation of the trophy. Second Belgian to win it. Justine Enna, 7 years ago, defeating Clijsters. And Clijsters in tears then in defeat. She lost four times in a major final before she won a U.S. Open. No woman had lost that many times in a final and then finally captured a major herself. Emotionally, it never gets old, does it? And we'll be back with the trophy presentation. The smile of victory from Kim Clijsters, Belgium.
This is Shake Weight for Men, and it's going.
Why not?
Sam Zenner to take us through the trophy presentation.
So many hearts this week. Ladies and gentlemen, our runner-up, Li Na.
Okay, first, of course, have congratulations for Kim. Have a good week here, and also best luck for the whole season. And of course, I have to thanks for my team, the two guys, not only one guy. So thanks for they stay behind me. I mean, they pushed me a lot. If they didn't stay behind me, I couldn't do anything. So thanks a lot. Yeah, thanks for the sponsor. And two things, can you see with the yellow t-shirt? This is my husband. I make a lot of joke for him, but doesn't matter you are fat or skinny, handsome or ugly. I always follow you, always love you. And I mean, I also a power for myself. Doesn't matter today win or lose because I tried my best at tennis already. And yeah, so 3rd of February is Chinese New Year. So I wish everyone happy Chinese New Year. All the best. And see you next year.
Thank you and congratulations once again to our runner-up, Li Na. Well, she's been out here for a number of years now. She's gone very, very close. She's been a finalist, but she hasn't been able to crack it until tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, our new champion of the Australian Women's Open Final is Kim Clijsters.
I'm a little shaky still, but first of all, congratulations to Li Na. It's been, you know, I've played so many matches against her throughout, you know, a number of years now already, and she's definitely a very tough competitor, and she had a great effort these last 2 weeks, and I think we'll have a lot of tough battles to come, so hopefully a few more Grand Slam finals together would be nice. Before I forget, and this probably has absolutely nothing to do with tennis, but on Saturday before I got here, I chipped my tooth at the airport, and I went to a dentist here in Melbourne, and he fixed me up really quickly, and it was, you know, before practice, and it was like so quickly, and I promised him that he said, yeah, just thank me if you get to the final. So I promised him, okay, for sure, I'll do that. So so thank you. And then, you know, obviously I want to thank all the sponsors. Kia, you know, has been a main sponsor for many years now. And I think, you know, it's probably very easy to see all the names on here and just think, oh yeah, you know, it's normal, but it's not normal these days. So I think, thank you very much for all the support. And, you know, I think without the sponsors and without all the volunteers and everybody, the ball kits and the drivers and everybody who make this event possible, you know, it just makes it so much easier for the players and for the whole group. So thank you everybody, to the whole team here at Tennis Australia. Thank you. I would also like to thank my box. It's always pretty full. First, I'm going to start with my uncle, because I've put him through a lot of trouble. Last year, I started, he came to my tournament when I won the championships in Doha, and he was wearing the ugliest green pants that I've ever seen. There he is. And I won, and so, you know, I'm superstitious. I said, look, you know, if you're going to come, you have to wear them every time. And he's like, oh, boy, you know. So those green pants have brought me a little bit of luck. So thank you, not just for the pants, but for your support. I would like to thank my coach, Wim. You know, we grew up playing together for many years. You know, I was always trying to beat him up as a younger girl. And, you know, it's a pleasure to be living all these dreams together now. So thank you very much for everything. My probably the guy I probably swear at the most is my fitness trainer. You know, when there's times that I feel really sore and I'm like, oh, you know, why is he on board? And he puts me through so much pain, but he puts me, this is the reason why. And I know that, and he always tells me and he motivates me. But Sam, thank you very much for everything. My manager, Bob, you know, he's not just a manager, he's one of our closest friends. And so thank you everything that you do for us, not just for me, but for my family. So thank you very much. And I mean, there's so many people, I can go on forever, but some I already said. Eve, Nicole, of course, my husband, Brian, who's probably the rock behind me. I'm on here on the court here by myself, but he's why, you know, I'm able to do this so much more easily. So thank you, Brian, very much. I love you. He gets a little shy. and then, yeah, Eve, Nicole, again, thank you very much. And then there's a junior, two juniors in our box, and she won the juniors today. So I want to congratulate Anne-Sophie for well done. And for the doubles, good job, girls. And then lastly, I just want to say that now I finally feel like you guys can call me Aussie Kim because I won the title. To the fans, thank you so much, obviously not just for the support, but not just here in Melbourne. I mean, I've been coming to Australia for many, many years, and you guys have been amazing. And even when things weren't going too good, you were always, you know, supportive of me, and I really, really appreciate it. And even today, it just helps so much, you know, to keep me out there focusing and fighting to try to get that title. So thank you very much to everybody out there. Thank you.
Congratulations, Kim. And the pair will now head down to the photographic pit, and the photos will be going right around the world as we take a short break, but lots more tennis still to come.
Well, that presentation by Kim Clijsters without a teleprompter, I mean, It's amazing how clever and complete she is in a situation like this with all the emotion to be able to remember everyone's name. And goodness, even without a dentist, an unknown dentist getting that tooth in place, and her uncle with the ugly green pants. And as Lena said, Happy New Year to all the Chinese people coming up the new year. And it's the year of the rabbit.
That's right.
But unfortunately for Lena, the woman who scampered best of all was Kim Clijsters, and she earns the trophy.
She really did, and you could just see the appreciation she has for her support group. She knows she couldn't have done it by herself, but on the court, she was on her own, she figured it out, and even though now she goes to number two in the world in the rankings, in a lot of people's minds, she's clearly the best player in the world, and I agree with Brad. I think she's got a great chance going forward at the next few majors, starting with the French, which she wasn't able to play last year. But her game, Dick, translates to every surface because she's such a great athlete, such a great mover. She's got the defense, she's got the offense, she can come forward. You saw the variety she had to use today to get things to go her way. So it's going to be tough for the rest of the field, I think, if this young woman keeps playing at this level.
Yeah, truly the difference between the two when you add up all the points was the fact that she does have more offensive and defensive firepower and the experience. And the last two sets played very cleanly. She had her problems in the first set, losing 6-3 and having trouble holding her serve. But the last two sets, just a very few errors. She let her opponent beat herself.
She has that ability. She really can change gears. She can play defensive when need be, and she did that today. But then she can step up, get inside the court, hit the big shot. She's got the big, powerful forehand, the solid backhand. She really can do it all. And we're seeing the best of her now in this comeback, which is so nice because for a while there, you felt that the pressure really got to Kim Clijsters. And now when the pressure's on is when she produces her best tennis. And that just shows a big sign of maturity.
And Lena.